Hello, my people. Hello, gorgeous. Hello, hot, sexy ladies. Okay. So, I'm here to quickly make a video, okay, on something different from what I usually talk about, okay? I just came back right now. I know you guys will be like, her face looks oily, but I love it. Okay, so I just want to talk about relationship, like guys, how to find a guy, or would I say how to find a husband, you know, because I know some ladies out there are really looking for a guy to settle down. Actually, I have a friend, which is kind of why I thought of making this video. So one of my friends is really, like, you know, looking for guys, he's been online, he's talking to a lot of guys. Personally, she was like, not she, I think most men get scared, or like it scares them to see her dress, because she, you know, she likes to be on point, she dressed well, she, you know, put a nice makeup, do her hair and take pictures and send to this guy. So she said that she found out that when she sent pictures to these guys, like where she's dressing well, that they get like intimidated, they kind of throws back. And she says she've had some people like, oh, you look like a high maintenance woman. Oh, where do you know? She said usually when she sent picture, they're like, oh, so where do you work? You know, so I just want to know what she's doing to be able to afford all those, you know, stuff. And some men don't really know that. Then when they see a woman dress up looking all good, they think, you know, they just think it's high maintenance. They don't even know that lots of women spend less to look good. You know, just, even me, like, most time I don't buy something like full price. It has to be on sale, especially clothes. Okay, not really hair. You know, hair's it's hard to find here on sale. But clothes, you know, like, oh, there's a clothes I was wearing last week. It's like a leather clothes. Oh my god, I got like compliment like all day. And I just bought, I went to a secondhand store called Fashion Runway. I got that clothes, and it's like a leather flare. It has cape, like it's so pretty. And you know how much I paid? $10, you know? But when you wear that kind of clothes with a nice boots and, you know, make your hair, you know, guys be like, okay, she's a celebrity. Like, seriously, I can't handle that one. Or seriously, I can, you know, take care of that one. So I just think, like, you know, to find a guy, you have to, you know, don't send them pictures where you're, like, looking all sexy, like, dressed up, like, jewelries and all that, okay? Just... and don't like dress too less, you know what I mean? Just be in the middle. I think they might be happy when after they get married to you, and then you can dress, and then at least they will know that you're not spending too much to dress too. So then when they see you looking all that hot, it kind of scares most guys, especially when they're trying to settle down. So for you to find a guy, I think we have to know what you're actually looking for in a guy, and also you also have to know what a guy is looking for in a woman, okay? It's not like you're gonna change just to be what a guy is looking for in a woman, but you know, even if it calls changing, you know, like that's what it's all about. So you're in a relationship with a guy, you sometimes your character and his character is not the same, so you guys probably have to change something just to kind of match up together. So what do you want in a man to settle down with? So I'm not talking about boyfriend here, I'm talking about like a guy you want to marry, if you're looking for a guy to settle down with, okay? I just wrote down some things. So you're looking for somebody you can, okay, first, I think the first thing is prayer. When you're looking to settle down, it's a big step, like you're trying to settle down with a guy, so it's really a big step. So, and it's something that lasts forever, for better, for worse. So you have to pray, like pray, you know, describe what you're looking for in your prayer. And you know, you have to have faith, like, you know, for God to answer a prayer, you have to do the right thing, okay? You won't just sleep around or do all that and pray and expect your prayers to be answered. You know, the Bible said that God answered the prayer of the righteous people. So you have to be, make sure you're in a good relationship with God, so that when you pray, he can, you know, hear you. So prayer is really, really important. Now, so when you put God first, then everything is easy. So you also have to look for someone you can confide in, you know, who will be your best friend. So that's another thing, you have to look in a man, you know, like somebody like me. Like if I have a problem, I have to make sure my husband, like I have to make sure I tell my husband almost everything. So I just want to make, so you just want to make sure that it's somebody you can like confide in, and it's somebody that can console you. You know, when you confide in somebody, that's why you're confiding in somebody, because you know the person will give you or will tell you something that will help you, especially when you're down, okay? And also someone that can apologize, like when you guys have problems, even though it's your fault. Like the lady, like I, which is one thing I love, like I can argue and argue. Women, I think most of women does that. We can argue forever, but we just want the guy to apologize. It is just natural. They have to apologize even though you're wrong. But anyway, you know, it's good for the woman to apologize too, but I think it's more good for the men to apologize. So you have to find somebody that listens well, a good listener, and also a communicator. That is, a communicating with somebody who wants to, you know, settle down is the best thing, because that's how you're gonna know them. That's true communication. You have to communicate to know them. If not, you might get married and you find out stuff that you don't even know. And somebody that is somebody that has a positive attitude, and somebody who is willing to do fun things with you, okay? So yeah, so when you're looking for a guy, you just have to find out somebody who is willing to do what you like, okay? And probably you're gonna be willing to do what he like, even though you don't really like them. So it's just about, you know, balance. So that's it. You know, I'm also referring to me, like, there are a lot of fun things I like to do. Something like going dancing, you know. If you find somebody that, even though, like, even though he don't like doing that, but somebody that can assure you that, you know, he will take you to places you want if he don't like to travel, but my wife or my fiance loves to travel, and he's willing to do all that with you, even though you don't like it. And this is vice versa, okay? So, violet. Make sure he's not violent. You know, somebody can, you know, try something to see how he's gonna react. Like, somebody like me can do that. I can just try something a little bit just to tempt, just to see. It's not like it's something I'm gonna be doing all the time, but I just want to like try to see how he's gonna react, if he's gonna like break everything and maybe take a knife and like, you know, yeah, with the knife. Then you run or you never come back. Then honest, you have to know somebody that's honest, you know, tell you the truth. Even though when they do wrong, they have to tell you the truth. Honest is very important, I tell you. Someone that is kind, that is nice. The guy's supposed to be kind, caring. Oh man, you have to care. Okay. So like a caring person, somebody that understands is good. So even when you make mistake as a woman, somebody that can explain things and they will be able to understand you, okay? And somebody that is patient with you, sincere, you know, thoughtful, and also somebody that have regard for your needs, okay? Whether sexually, whatever, emotionally, like he, you know, he's there for you. And it's gonna be, as when I say sexually, is like, you know, after you guys got married, like I say, you know. So that's it. And somebody that is that also will help in household work, okay? Yeah, that's another thing with me, okay? Like, you have to wash plates. You have to know how to wash plates. Cook sometimes, okay? I love men that can cook. Yeah, you have to cook once in a while, okay? That's what I mean. I don't really know how to cook American food, so most of the time my husband does all the cooking. I do cooking, like I do jollof rice, I do, you know, like African thing. But my husband, you know, he prefers his American food, but that's how he grew up. So he cooks, and I think the first thing for me, the first thing in a man would be like, can you cook? So yeah, someone that is willing to do all that, you know, sometimes help you wash it. Even though you're cooking, he can, you know, help, you know, wash the car and buy you gas, okay? So I'm gonna be a spoiled one, because it's crazy. I've been driving for like 4 years, 5 years now in America, and I haven't bought gas for once. So mine is probably stupid. Like, I'm gonna learn how to buy a gas. Like, I don't know how to buy a gas. Like, you guys would be like, seriously? But yeah, seriously. But you know, it's not overdoing. Mine probably, you know, I just, because my husband does it, I just like, I don't care. So I have to learn how to buy, because I don't even know how to go to a police station and buy a gas. So he does that for me, which is super, super nice. But then sometimes I'm like, you know, I think you're stupid. You have to get up and learn something. So, but you know, something that is we do that is not like doing it all the time like mine does, but you know, once in a while, you know, he's just surprised you. Oh honey, did you see your tank? I just get it full. Where again? And also, another thing is being in the same religion. I just want to talk about religion. Sometimes when you know, getting married in the lot, okay, when two people are in different religion, it kind of brings division or something like that. So you have to be in the same religion. I don't know. Somebody that likes to travel, especially if you're somebody that likes to travel, you know, somebody that is polite, you know, similar interests. I don't know about, even though you guys don't really have similar interests, like I say, relationship is about, you know, trying to do whatever your partner likes to do, even though you don't like it. Like, you know, you gotta try to, you just, it's all about changing, because this is two different people. They are totally two different people. So you have to try to get used to what your hobby or what your wife likes, okay? So this is probably, you know, what you have to look for a man. And also, to find a man, also you have to put yourself in a situation to meet that man you're looking for. You have to, you're looking for this man, if you want to meet him, like, you don't have, like, going to work all day, coming home, you know, sometimes you can't meet a guy like that. You have to, like, spread out, okay, widen out, like, do stuff, like, hang out with friends, go to dinner, maybe go, you know, go to Bible study, you know, where you know you can meet men. Also online, because, you know, a lot of people work this time, sometimes they don't really have time to do all that. So you can also be online, which is where a lot of people also meet. So this is what you find out. So this is how you can find a man of your choice. And then what about you? Because a man too is looking for something in a woman. They want a woman that makes them feel like a man. Sometimes they don't want a woman to dominate, right? Yeah, so you just have to allow them to be a man, okay? So don't just be like, you know, sometimes like, oh, you're too, like, let's him control some things. Even though I know here in America, most men want to be the, you know, they want to just say it and that's how it is. But sometimes just let the man to be a man and just say it. So you just have to respect them. And that's why men are looking for, women that respect them. You know, be fun, just don't make everything too hard or like you have to be this. Just play, laugh with your husband, okay? Even though, even before he becomes your husband, you know, you just, you guys just have fun together. Tell, you know, show him that you're a good woman, okay? Especially if you are. So, they want a woman that is passionately, who passionately love her own life, not miserable, okay? So you have to love your own life as a woman. So they don't want you to feel, they don't want to feel like, oh, you know, you're already miserable, okay? Like, it's only when you have a man that you will be good. It doesn't work that, like, so just don't show them that you're miserable anyway. That's what it is. Just show them that you're happy even without a man, okay? So probably the man will make you more happy, but still, like, be happy, like, do fun things, like, you know, just show it. A woman, they want a woman who is physically attractive and who know it, okay? Even though you're not physically attractive, like, however you look like, they just want you to be confident of how you look like, okay? So don't just be like, don't just tell a man, oh my gosh, I'm fat, I'm ugly. Don't say that. Just be like, oh, you know, just don't even, even though you don't say, oh, I'm hot, but just be proud of who you are. Do you understand? So, and also, they also want honest and somebody trustworthy, okay? So you have to be honest with any guy you're dating, and trustworthy, and a woman who knows how to communicate her needs, you know? Somebody, a woman who can support a man with a positive attitude, a woman who is soft and feminine, you know, so that's it. So yeah, so men like a woman to also support them, okay, whatever they are going through, whatever, you just be there for them, give them, talk to them. So as much as you know what you're looking for in a man, you also have to know what a man is looking for in a woman, so you can also, like, be that thing a man is looking for in a woman. I think that's all. I'm gonna pause this and think for a while. Anyway, sweet people, I can't think of anything else, but let me know, okay, what other things you think a woman's supposed to do. You know, this is all about sharing, you know, helping women who are out there, who are single, who are still looking. So whatever thing, whatever thing you have, you know, we all have stuff in our mind. So whatever thing you want to share, you can just put it down here and tell us what you think or how you think a woman can find a husband. And I think I'll make a video on this one. There's something in my mind, but I'm not gonna say it. But anyway, just share what you think. Just comment anything. Okay. Love you guys, and I hope to talk to you guys later.